Sir, started, sir. Recording has been started.
Okay. It is an honor and great privilege for me to welcome you all on behalf of Library Committee in today's online book talk program. I especially extend my warm welcome to our worthy director and principal, Dr. Ajit Gupta, HOD PG Department, Dr. Murai Sharma, HOD UG Department, Dr. Ronika Sharma, Deputy HODs, faculty members, and dear students. A book talk is a short presentation about a book with the goal of convincing other people to read it. It is not a formal book report or review. In a book talk program, the goal is to engage the listeners and present an exciting and even suspenseful presentation about a book so that the listeners become eager to read the book. With these words, I would like to call book talk participants one by one. Today's program, our book talkers are our esteemed teachers who has vast experience of teaching in their respective fields. Now I start with Dr. Monica Bajaj, Deputy HOD, Meyer College of Education. Dr. Monica Bajaj, please.
Yes. Thank you, sir. Thank you. Good afternoon, everyone. So this is a great initiative by you, sir, for organizing this in this by online mode. So I am here just to give you brief about the two books, which I suppose like it will be beneficial. These books will be beneficial for all the students, whether they are doing B.Ed. or whether they are doing M.Ed. course. These books may be somewhere related to their course curriculum also, and somewhere it is helpful in their competitive exams. And both the books are available online. So I am sharing with the students both the books title cover. So one book is of environmental education, right? And that environmental education book is our B.Ed. students, they have opted for environmental education as one of the subject. So they can get, those have opted for this as a, you can say, subject, they can take maximum help from this book because it will giving them benefit for studying their topics, as well as because maximum competitive exams, this book can help them for their preparation. I hope it is visible to everyone.
Yes, ma'am.
So this is a textbook for environmental studies, and it is recommended by UGC, written by Eric Barucha, and they have recommended it for all undergraduate courses, for all branches of higher education. This book is good because this gives basic of the environment. Maximum of the topics of B.Ed. course, the students, those who have opted for environmental education, they can go for this online, and it is available free of cost. They can have their 70% of the syllabus is available in this particular book. So I hope and believe that you will all read this, and for competitive exams, like there are basic topics in this book for meaning of environment and its basic components, different kinds of resources, the role of a human being or as an individual in conservation of environment, how can you do different kind of strategies, role of different organizations. Book basically comprised of...
I request the other participants, please switch off your mic. Please switch off your mic. Sunil Soni, ma'am. Please switch off your mic. Switch off your mic.
Okay.
When your turn will come, I will call you. Then switch on your mic, please. Okay, start, Monica, ma'am. Continue, Monica, ma'am. Continue, please.
Yes. So this book is important, sir. I am audible. Am I audible?
Yes, ma'am.
You are audible.
Okay. So this book is important, and I also want to share the link with you people. You can note down, or and I will share it with you in the classroom also, because you can take help from this from the internet, and the link is very easy. You can simply type and you can download it free of cost, right? So the thing is, it will be beneficial. One thing is important, that it will be beneficial for your course, one thing. The another thing is, like, it will be helpful for you for competitive exams, because in if you have experienced in every competitive exams, you might be having 5 to 6 questions of environment, and these questions are simply basic questions. And if you don't read, all of you students, if you don't read about the environment, then you will fail in those 5 questions. So you can get that 5 questions from this simple book, and it is in simple language, and most importantly recommended by UGC, which is the highest body in education sector. So you can go for this kind of book also. I hope this is okay for this book. Then I can share with the you with the other book. Yes, any question regarding this particular thing? Yes, students.
No ma'am.
Okay, the another book is that is Basics in Education, which I think it will be read by many of you, and in first semester you all have gone through these types of topics, right? Now what happens when we go for competitive exams, and even in our other semesters, the concepts of education are important, and we forget many times the basic we have read in our previous semesters. So this is also free of cost, available online, and you can go for the that kind this book also, right? I am sharing the cover page of that page, that book also. That is, the name is Basics in Education, and it is specifically meant for B.Ed course, but I believe for M.Ed students also this is helpful, because you all are in education sector, and this book is written under the supervision of NCERT, which is an important body, and the books published by NCERT, they are basically good. I should say they are good. Their language, the words, vocabulary, and other things, they all are right, very nice. So you can go with this book for your general knowledge also, and for your competitive exams also. And if you want to just go through about the education system or basic concepts of education, so we have different kinds of topics in this book, which will be really beneficial for you people. You all are going to be future teachers, and this definitely going to be help you students. And it is also in simple language, so I think you should go for reading this book also. So I am sharing link with you people, right? So that you can note down, and you can just download it from the internet, right? Just a minute. Just a minute. So I think the links are visible to you.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes,
you can note down the links for downloading the books. These are available free of cost. A very small size book, like for environmental studies, it is of 361 pages, but for reading it is around 200 pages and 3.5 MB size only. And the other book for basics in education, it is also of smaller size. You can download it. Within 4 to 5 minutes. So I hope and believe that you people will take advantages of these both books and get benefit. Thank you so much.
Bajaj ma'am, inko na copy karke paste maar dijiye chat box mein. Thank you.
Okay, sir. Thank you so much, sir.
वेलकम बोला सर. थैंक यू मोनिका मैम. नाउ आई रिक्वेस्ट साइका बानू मैम टू प्लीज प्रेजेंट. साइका बानू फ्रॉम पीजी डिपार्टमेंट.
गुड आफ्टरनून एवरीवन.
गुड आफ्टरनून.
Before I begin my talk, I would like to share an excerpt from the book with all of you. Assessment has always been an integral part of education. However, current educational environment demands a greater emphasis on psychological aspects of the teaching-learning process. The scientific understanding of behavior and mental processes as derived from psychology can be operationalized for effective and empowering education that is needed in 21st century through the use of appropriate psychological texts. So students, you all might have got a clue regarding the book I'm going to talk about. I hope so. Well, it's Applied Psychometry. I hope it is visible to all of you, the slide.
Yes, ma'am.
Screen. Okay. The author of the book is Narendra Kumar Chadha and publisher is Sage Publications. Well, students, different books are available, but why I have chosen this book is that the reason is that if you have a look at the contents of this book, you will find that it covers most of the content as prescribed in your syllabus. I will just show you the contents of the book. So here, have a look at it. We have the part one, which deals with the measurement in modern psychological research, in which one of the topic that is given in your syllabus in your first unit is errors in measurement. So that falls in first unit. Then if you have a look at the second part of this book, that is the theory and practice of psychological testing. And in this part, you can find the topics like test construction, introduction to psychological testing, item analysis, scoring of tests, then reliability, validity, norms. These all makes the unit second and unit third of your syllabus. And then if you have a look at the part third, which is the applications of psychological testing, so this makes the unit fourth of your course, the applications of psychological testing in educational setting, in counseling and guidance, and in clinical settings. And the part fourth, which is about the ethical issues in psychological testing, this is also given in your syllabus in first unit. So it means that it covers most of the topics that are given in your syllabus. And if you see, it meets the requirements of all the learners. The language is quite simple, clear, and easy to understand. And the topics which are given in this book are explained comprehensively, and content is also sufficient from the examination point of view. Nowadays, as we all know that due to pandemic, all the educational institutions are closed and students do not have any access to libraries. As such, the only available resource for all of you is the online resource. This is one, and this is another reason of choosing this book, as this book has been uploaded by Isha ma'am in your Google Classroom, and you can have easy access to it. So students, I suggest that you all should go through this book, as it is a very good book for the course testing in education. So happy reading, and thank you everyone.
Thank you, ma'am. Thank you, ma'am. Thank you so much for explaining it wonderfully, and students will came to know that how they can use this book for what type of topics they can cater in this book. Thank you so much. Sunil ji, Sunil sir.
Now I request Poonam Soni ma'am to please give the book talk of your book. Poonam Soni ma'am.
Good afternoon, all of you.
Good afternoon, ma'am.
I, Poonam Soni, recommend this book. This is Fundamentals of Guidance and Counseling. I find this book a very good book, which can be used by B.Ed. students of semester 3. And this book covers nearly 90% of the syllabus. And the language is also very simple. And content is enough from examination point of view. So this book, I find that this book, I have read this book, and I also ask you people, I also request you people to read this book. And then you will be able to get very good marks in the examination. And this is covering majority of the syllabus, that is 90% of the syllabus. So that is all about the book. You can see this book, it is found in the library. We have got this in this library also. And last of all, I congratulate Sunil ji and Isha ji for organizing such a beautiful program. Thank you.
Thank you, Soni ma'am. Now I request Mrs. Komal Sharma to please continue with book talk.
Good morning, good afternoon, everyone. Good afternoon, Moolraj sir, the deputy HODs, HODs, and the entire faculty and students of our college. And we are here to talk about the books which are you know, easy to understand and which can help you out in making your notes and understanding the concepts. So I'll be sharing with you a book which is regarding your course number 302, that is Gender, School and Society. So although we have completed with the syllabus of this paper, but still I would like to suggest you a book which can help you in preparing your notes and understanding the concepts which you are finding otherwise a little difficult. So I would suggest you this Transforming Gender Studies. So is it visible clearly to all of you?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Right. So this is the book, and it is Transforming Gender Studies by Premlata Arora. So this book has a very it has a very easy language, and it has a comprehensive, you can say, elaboration of concepts. Although it is it does not contain all the topics of your syllabus, but still you will find a lot of material which can supplement the topics that are there in your syllabus. So you can go through it, you can find some important topics in it. So this book has, although 259 pages and a well you know, a constructed bibliography and a proper explanation of all the terms at the end, you can refer to them as far as some difficult terms are concerned. You can have them supplemented. So it has some important topics like transforming gender roles. Like we have an in our syllabus that the difference between you know, various roles of gender means the males and the females, and those roles can be better understood. And here you have gender and culture, which will also help you in topics like equity and equality, which is your topic in first unit 1.2, equity and equality with respect to caste, class, region, religion, ethnicity. So here you will find gender and culture, and also you will find gender and socialization, where this topic will be very, very clear to you if you go through this part. And then you have gender rights in education, which is probably related to your unit 2, where you have gender and education and access to education and resistance, where you will come to know about various rights of education that we have as far as the gender is concerned. Then gender mainstreaming strategies are there, where we can apply various strategies in order to maintain the gender equity and equality as far as education is concerned. Gender and sexuality, again, we have a concept in this paper regarding the difference between the gender and the sex, and what are the major points of distinction between both, and the concepts related to that. Then gender mainstreaming and empowering. So we have women empowerment, we have historical backdrops also in this book regarding what has been there since the early times till the changes that have happened as far as the gender or the women empowerment is concerned. So I suggest you that you go through this book. It will really help you in making certain concepts easier to understand and preparing your notes. Although I also recommend you the two more books which will be discussed by Dr. Rita Divedi and Mrs. Suman Devi ma'am, as they were also teaching the same paper, that is Gender School and Society by Naushad Hussain and Gender School and Society by Ritu Mangu. So these books will cover up more of your syllabus and will have more of the topics that are there in your syllabi. But still, in order to understand those topics thoroughly, you can consult this book. That is all I wanted to say about it. You can get the photocopies done from the library, or we can help you out in getting the photocopies done and uploading it. So that's all I wanted to say. Thank you so much.
Thank you, Komal ma'am, for your wonderful presentation. Now I request Dr. Rita Divedi to please present the book talk. Dr. Rita. You are not audible.
Okay.
Now, okay.
So, good afternoon, everyone.
Good afternoon, ma'am.
Good afternoon.
So, is it audible, sir?
Yes, yes.
Okay, so like Komal ma'am, I will also speak on the book, which title is Gender, School and Society. It is written by Professor Naushad Hussain. It was first published in...
Rita ma'am, your sound is not so clear. Please speak loud.
Hello. Sir, yes, maybe maybe there is some technical issue. Otherwise, I am speaking loudly. My voice is not slow.
Okay, ma'am. Okay. It is okay now.
Now it's audible?
Yes, yes, ma'am.
So now I am coming closer. Okay. So the title of the book is Gender, School and Society. It is written by Professor Naushad Hussain. And it was first... is it visible to everyone? Students, can you see the book?
No, ma'am. Is it? No, it's not visible. Ma'am.
Yes,
not
ma'am.
Visible, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am. It's visible. Yes, ma'am.
So this book was first published in India. This is the first edition in 2018. And it covers almost 80% of the syllabus. The charm of the book is its language, which is very simple and written in lucid style. So it is available in our library. And as you know, why I am referring this book, as you know, this is included in your course, but for the MED students also, if they want to know certain aspects about the society and gender, like it is a guiding note by NCTE that you can see the meaning and experience of being a boy or a girl is not the same across different social groups, regions and time periods, and to examine how we learn and challenge these gender roles in society through a variety of institutions such as family, caste, religion, culture, media, law and the state. The unequal access of education to girls is a well documented reality, as you know, but the concerns of gender just education go beyond access to schools. Gender identity construction is influenced by forces at home and in society. So to know all these aspects, you can consult this book. This is a very book, a good book, and for the access, you can even contact with us, or you can contact to Sunil sir, or even if you will ask, we will be, like Komal ma'am has already told, that we will be uploading the material in the Google Classroom. We have already provided you the content material, but if you want to enrich your content more, so you can add some of the content from this book, as almost you can see this in this book, only one subunit is lacking, that is 3.2. Rest all the subunits are covered, so all the subunits are given in very elaborate, very comprehensive. So go for this book, and this is all about this book. Thank you so much.
Thank you, Rita ma'am.
Thank you so much.
Now I request Dr. Bharati Tandon ma'am from BG department, please present the book talk.
A very good afternoon. Can you all hear and see?
Yes ma'am, you are audible.
Okay, is the video on, because I can't see here?
Yes, it is on, you are visible.
All right, a very good afternoon, and you know, I would first like to thank Sunil sir and Isha ma'am for organizing such a you know, wonderful and informative you know, a program, which is a book talk. I'm going to talk about mental health, because we all have, you know, gone through a lot if we consider the pandemic and the situation that happened for last 9 months. So I think the mental health area, or the mental health of everybody actually, was impacted by it. So this is a book that I'm going to share. You know, it could be a general read, including there's one particular course in MA education, which is MAE 309 Mental Health. We are talking about ebooks. The reason behind is because you know, since you all cannot, especially the students, you can't come to college and can have an accessibility to the library, you know, physically have a accessibility to print books, you know, the hard copy or print copy books. So one book I'll be talking in particular that actually is already uploaded in your Google Classroom. I'll come to that later, but first I like to talk about, you know, there are platforms where you can download free ebooks. I think a few days ago there was an orientation about the National Digital Library, and you all must be in the process or have already created accounts for that, and you can download the books. If you just type in you know, the mental health books, you will come across a list of mental health books, and there are mental health books that are covering a part or the entire syllabus that we have for MAE 309. Then there's another website that is free psychotherapybooks.org. if you go to that website, again you can download the books. But the one that I would refer to when you are on NDLI, that is the Mental Health and Disorder by Christina Vito, or you can also look at, for your own understanding, the Encyclopedia of Mental Health. So coming back to the book, which is already there on your Google Classroom, that book is, you know, the Mental Health and Hygiene by Dr. Kajal Manas, and it is published in the year 2013, and the publisher is Narendra Publishing House. So I'm going to quickly share just the cover page of that book, so that, you know, when you go and open, you know, the resource material which is already there on your Google Classroom, you are able to actually see that book, you know, uploaded. Just give me a second. I think it should come up on your screen pretty quick. Okay, you all can see, right? It is visible, right?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. So just on this first one, that is right there in on your screen is Mental Health and Hygiene. And I think the cover is actually very explicit and talks about the mental health and the issues that are there. So obviously I told you it has been written by Dr. Kajal Manas, and she is a professor at the University of Jammu. And if we just scroll down, just to give you an idea what different topics that would be covered in specific to the syllabus, and also for your general read, you can read it. Students from both UG and PG department, they can go through the different topics that are being covered in this. Especially the students from MA, they talked about that they are finding, you know, difficulty in looking for material like, the role of community. So if you open up this book, you'll find there's an entire, chapter that talks about the role of community in prevention of mental illness and preservation of mental health. So I think that in addition to other, the content that you can look for, the material that you can look for, I think there is a chapter that talks about the community which you are finding little difficult to find the information. So I think Isha ma'am has really worked hard to look at book that covers up which part of your syllabus which is not readily available online or in other websites, or what you're looking for the university websites. So I would suggest that you just go through this book, and I will also encourage other students, both from UG and PG department, from MED also. Even if you don't have your, this course on mental health, but going through it, you can understand the components of your mental health as well as, the mental health of other family members in the community and such. So I'll just, put an end to my explanation and the talking about a particular book talk. So thank you so much, and all the best, and happy puja break. Thank you, sir.
Thank you Bharti ma'am for your wonderful presentation. Now I request to Suman Gupta ma'am, please present the book talk.
Okay, sir. Okay, sir. Good afternoon, all.
Good afternoon.
As you all know that in third semester, at present, I am teaching you action research, that is 303 paper. So I am talking about the book, this book, Methodology of Educational Research. Are you able to see the book?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes. So this book is of fourth revised edition in 2015, and the author of this book is Lokesh Pol, Professor, Himachal Pradesh University, Shimla, by Vikas Publishing House. And also this book is available online also, and this book covers about 70% course of action research of third semester. This book covers maximum topics of theory as well as practical aspects.
So in practical aspect, that is in statistics, mean, median, mode, correlation, and significance of difference between means, graphical representation of data, etc. These all are very good elaborated terms. And so there are so many examples also related to these topics to practice. So I recommend this book for both PG and UG department, because this book is beneficial for your competitive point of view. Competitive exam, there are so many questions related to research. As I have given you all the reference material of all the topics of action research, that is 303, but yet if anyone want to take the material of any topic, I am referring this book. You can consult to Sunil sir, librarian of the college, to get this book, and also you can photocopy any topic from this book. As per my opinion, this is the best book for action research 303, because it covers maximum topics of theory and practical both of 303, so you can consult it. Thank you. Thank you, Sunil sir and Isha ma'am.
Thank you, Suman ma'am. Now I request Arpana ma'am. Ms. Arpana,
yes, sir. Present
a book talk.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Good afternoon, everyone.
Good afternoon.
Good afternoon, ma'am. Sir, my screen is visible. Sir,
yes,
my
screen. Ma'am. Yes, ma'am.
I am sharing the title paper of this book. Is this visible?
No, it is not visible. Just select the screen share option and wait. Then Firstly, you select the screen share.
Is this visible now?
Yes, now it is visible.
So I would like to share about the book, which is the title of the book is Research Methodology, Methods and Techniques, and this book is written by Dr. D.R. Kapoor and Ms. Pooja Saigal, and it is of Regal Publications, New Delhi. This book is based on the research. So this book will be helpful for both B.Ed. as well as B.Ed. special students. In B.Ed. semester 3, you people are having course 303, which is action research. Most of the topics which you have in the syllabus of action research, you can find those topics here in this book. And this book is also helpful for the B.Ed. special students, because in semester 4, you will have a paper 403, Basic Research and Statistics. There also you will find some topics of research and statistics that will be available in this book. This is the content of the book. In Unit 1, you will have the topics like research and its characteristics, research paradigm, fundamental applied in action research. This is the description of the whole content which is given in the book. This is about Unit 1. Here it is Unit 2. This is Unit 3. This is Unit 4. And Unit 5. So I find this book helpful for both B.Ed. and B.Ed. special students, as this book covers most of the topics which is in your syllabus. And we find that in Unit 1, it deals with the meaning, nature and scope of research, topics such as scientific inquiry, types of research, namely fundamental, applied, action research, development of theory, quantitative and qualitative research, areas of educational research. These all the topics are covered in Unit 1 with the help of some examples. They're also giving some examples related to these topics are also given in this book. Unit 2 includes various steps for the formulation of research proposals, sources for identification of problem, strategies for literature review. In semester 3 for B.Ed. In action research paper, your sessional work is to prepare a research proposal, action research plan. So this book would also help in preparing that plan. In your semester 4, you have to implement that plan. So this book would be helpful for you people that time to how to identify a problem, how to make the objectives, and how to conduct the research. So in Unit 3, It deals with the development and construction of various tests, questionnaires, skills and observation, interview, sociometric techniques, etc. Unit 4 includes qualitative research, methods like various types of research, grounded theory, historical methods, field studies, and Unit 5 deals with the classification of data, metric and non-metric, univariate, bivariate and multivariate, descriptive and inferential statistics. So I recommend this book for both BEd and BEd special students. And So this was all about the book. Thank you.
Thank you, Arpana. Now I request Ms. Suman Devi to please start your book talk.
Thank you, sir. Good afternoon to everyone.
Good afternoon.
Your syllabus, in your syllabus, course code 302, Gender, School and Society. This book, the Gender, School and Society, has been written by Dr. Ritu Mango and Dipti Agarwal. Visible? This book is visible?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. This book published by Neel Kamal Publications Private Limited, Educational Publishers. The book Gender, School and Society on attention to gender relations are the gender matters in the society. Gender relations are the ways in which a society defines rights, responsibilities and identities of men and women in relation to one another. When we relate gender with community, development is very important to change the perspective of men towards women. Unless and until the perspective of the people does not change about towards women, they are somehow always to be dominated in the society. When we talk about gender and community development, it is very important and there is gender equity in the society. Its main purpose is to sensitize each stakeholder on gender issues in our education system in Indian context. The book covers comprehensive data on the different related concepts of sex and gender issues in education system, as well as problems and strategies to overcome these difficulties. Okay, the language of the book is very simple and easy. I have already in section B, I have already provided you all material what you can consult in this book. This book is available in our college library. This book is very beneficial for students to understand that. In end, I will suggest everyone to please go through the book and make the most out of it. Okay, thank you.
Thank you, Suman ma'am. Now I request Dr. Bindu Dua from PG department, please present your book talk.
A very good afternoon to everyone and all. So day before yesterday, I was told to talk about a book. And when I was going through the books, I found a quote, I think, which is very simple and it applies for all of us as a teacher and as well as for the students who are already in the line of learning. Books give a soul to the universe, wings to the mind, flight to imagination and life to everything. So we can say that life without the books is not possible. So let's begin with the book talk. I am teaching MH students 306, that is pedagogy on assessment of secondary and higher secondary school education, that is related to the curriculum. So the book which I have rather discussed about while teaching you, because in this syllabus you have the movie, you have to discuss about most of the policies that may be the NP 1986 or 1992, or we have that Mudaliar Commission or Kothari Commission, or we have this you can say the National Curriculum Framework 2005 or 2000, or National Knowledge Commission. So the book which I found to be useful for you people is this is Contemporary India and Education by Nushad Hussain. I'll just show you the cover page of this book. I think the cover page is visible to you. Yes, can you see the cover page?
Yes, ma'am.
This book will not cover the whole of the syllabus, but it covers some of the portion of your syllabus that is from unit, you can say one, that is the NCF 2000 and 2005 or RAMSA, and then your fourth unit, that is, you can say the education, secondary education during the British period, that is the pre-independence, and the secondary education, that is the post-independence, that is the after-independence. So you have Mudaliar Commission. I think this book covers that also in a very comprehensive manner and according to the examination point of view also. Then the Kothari Commission, then that is National Policy on Education 1986-92. Then knowledge, National Knowledge Commission, major recommendations for secondary education. And then one is that ICT school scheme. These all topics are covered in this book. So this book, the portion which is being covered in your syllabus has already been uploaded in the Google Classroom by our librarian Isha. She has done a tremendous job in this field and she has already uploaded. I told her, okay, this is the syllabus and kindly please upload you can say the portion which is related to the syllabus. She has already uploaded. You can see Google Classroom, go through the book and I think it will cater to your needs. Thank you everyone. And thank you Sunil ji for organizing this program. Even Isha, thank you.
Thank you so much. Thank you, Bindu ma'am, for your wonderful presentation.
Thank you, ma'am.
Now I request Isha Sharma to please present a vote of thanks. Yes, Isha ma'am.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Before vote of thanks, I would like to share my screen.
Okay.
It gives me an immense pleasure to convey vote of thanks on behalf of Library Committee, Meyer College of Education. First and foremost, I would like to thank our worthy principal and director, Meyer College of Education, Dr. Adit Gupta, for his continuous support in absentia. His guidance has always encouraged us. I extend my thanks to our heads, Dr. Moolraj, HOD PG Department, Dr. Ronika Sharma, HOD UG Department in absentia, deputy heads and all staff members of Meyer College of Education for gracing the occasion. I'm thankful to all the participants, Dr. Bindu Dua, Dr. Bharti Tandon, Mrs. Saika Banu, Dr. Monica Bajaj, Mrs. Poonam Soni, Mrs. Komal Sharma, Dr. Rita Divedi, Mrs. Arpana Kaul, Mrs. Suman Gupta, and Mrs. Suman Devi for participating in an excellent manner and sparing their valuable time. I also extend my thanks to all the students for patient listening. Last but not the least, I am thankful to each and everyone who is involved directly or indirectly for making this event a great success. Thank you, one and all.
Thank you, Isha ma'am. With these words, I thank you to all the participants for taking the part in this book talk program and make this event a grand success. Thank you.
Thank you, sir. Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you, sir, Anisha ma'am.
Now you can leave the meet.